there's a new feature inside of Camera Raw that's going to help you get much better results on all your photographs. Now, the first thing you should do is apply a profile when you open a photo. Those are not new, but the adaptive profiles inside of Camera Raw are. Let's have a look at them right now. And by the way, you might have seen a similar video a few days ago from me that was up for a few hours. Because of a little bit of a mix-up, I had to take that video down. So now this is the brand new video with the updated and correct information. Let's jump in. So this part's really important for you to see the adaptive profiles. If you're working in Photoshop and then you choose Filter, Camera Raw Filter, and you click on the profiles, you notice that they're not going to be there. That's because we're working on a JPEG image. So the first thing we want to do is make sure that we have a RAW file. And then we're in Bridge right now. I can right click and I can choose Open in Camera Raw. If I'm in Photoshop, I can choose File Open and make sure I choose a RAW file and it will open it in here. But we can also open a RAW file in Photoshop from Lightroom. I'll show how to do that later on in the video. All right, so here we are with the photo, unedited, no adjustments. So the first thing you want to do when you open a photo to get the best results is to apply a profile. We can see right here it says a profile Adobe Color. Now what we want to do is go to the profile browser and click. And notice now we see different profiles. Profiles are not new. They've been in Camera Raw and also in Lightroom for quite a while. But this new feature that is just inside of Camera Raw right now. So if we look at a color profile, notice by default it chooses Adobe Color. Now a profile is the way that Camera Raw interprets that RAW file and displays it. Now this is before any adjustments and it works independently of any of the adjustments inside of Camera Raw. So if we roll over, we can see these are different ones. But let's go down a little bit. You're going to see camera matching. If you're working with a RAW file, you're going to see these options. You won't see these with a JPEG, but these are the settings you'd see on your camera. Things like standard, faithful, landscape, portrait, neutral. Those are the settings from your camera that are brought in with the RAW file. Now, Sony, Nikon, different camera manufacturers, Fuji also have these. Now, these are the Adobe ones we're looking at right now. So we could choose things like Adobe Color, Monochrome. Notice as I roll over these, you can see that it really influences the way that this image starts. And this is really, really important at the beginning of the image to get the best possible starting place. Now, let's say we've got Adobe Color right now. Let's roll down. And if we go down, we're going to see one called Adaptive. Now, these are beta profiles. Now, the color one is not new. It's been in there before. But if we look at this and we see, here's our image. Now, we roll over the Adaptive Color. Notice how we see a lot more detail here in the Grand Canyon and notice in the clouds there. It's just really making that photo pop if we use that as a starting place. Now, the new one that was added recently is the grayscale. So let's have a look at Adobe Monochrome. And then once again, this is the starting place. We can make adjustments later. And this is how it's going to interpret it. Now, all these profiles are not taking into account the individual image. These are just presets that are going to apply no matter what the image is. What makes the adaptive profiles different is it uses AI to analyze the photograph and then build a custom profile for that individual photo to give you the best possible starting place. So if we look at this grayscale one right now, notice this is what we've got. This is actually pretty good. But if we go down over the adaptive, notice a big difference. So where would we see this difference? Let's take, for example, let's look at the trees in the bottom left corner. As a starting place, we can see a lot more detail there. Let's look at the clouds. Right now, this is the Adobe Monochrome attached. Once you click, then it will apply that profile. So the clicked one was the regular one. Look at the clouds. And we see the clouds in the sky, not a ton of separation. If I roll over the adaptive one, notice that before, after, much more definition there in the clouds. More details down here in the Grand Canyon, particularly in the shadow areas. So here's the thing. Let's apply this monochrome. We can adjust the intensity of it with the amount slider. But if we want to go now and we choose the back button, notice none of these adjustments have been changed yet. All we've done is apply the profile, given ourselves a great starting place. So now I may pull back on the highlights a little bit. And I may even pull back on the exposure a little bit, just to suit my taste, and maybe we'll pop open these shadows a touch. And notice now we're able to adjust these independently of the profile. Like maybe you want to kick some blacks in there. Let's just do that right now. If I go under the profiles here, I could choose different profiles. Notice I changed that, but as I do, our adjustments are intact, which means that we can use this independently. And notice that those adjustments don't change when we change the profile. Those are completely independent. All right, now let me show you how to get photos in from Lightroom Classic into Photoshop Camera Raw while maintaining their rawness. My previous tutorial on reflection removal, some people had trouble getting those raw files from Lightroom into Camera Raw. So this will also apply to you, and this will show you how to always do that. So you're just gonna right click, and then you're gonna choose to edit in. But rather than editing it in Photoshop, so if we bring this into Photoshop, it's just gonna create a PSD or a TIFF depending on your settings. So what we wanna do is go down to open as a smart object in Photoshop, and this will keep it as a raw file. Now it's gonna launch Photoshop, and you'll see there's our smart object. If we double click, now it's gonna open in Camera Raw. All right, so here we are. Let's have a look at the profiles. So we can see right now we're using the Adobe color profile. And we're gonna go to adaptive. Notice that those are beta profiles. So let's roll over the profile and look at the difference. There's Adobe color, there's the adaptive. Before, after. Look how much more detail showing in the rocks, in the water, the sky, before, after. So we're gonna apply this profile, and then you're just gonna choose the back button. Notice when we go to the back button, none of our adjustments have been made. We're just starting with the profile. So we still have the ability to make all of these adjustments, but this is just gonna give us a much better starting place, and it's gonna help us achieve better images. So thanks for watching this video. I hope you learned something new. Let me know in the comments underneath. And if you wanna know more about the new features inside of Camera Raw, check out this video right here. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.